he was on Let It Be, and they got on real well. And Billy loved the band, and they loved Billy. John actually said, come on, Billy, do a little of your gospel piano. It's about God, you know. So he inspired him to do something about his, you know, something that's his upbringing. Billy learned piano playing and organ playing in church. And that's, he really believed in God, and that's the way he plays on this song. It's beautiful.
It's interesting just hearing the two sounds of the pianos, actually. I mean, one is a normal classical piano, a Steinway piano, which Billy Preston played. And then we've got the honky-tonk piano, which is a simpler playing, just a rhythm piano, which is what John played. Both Steinway pianos, but just a totally different sound. I'll just solo the drums here, just to give you... Just interesting, just hearing these... And the fact that each one of these tom fills, are all different.
I've never done a fill the same twice. Because when I do it, it's where I'm at that moment, you know. And so if you want to then re-record that track, I'll do a fill in that space, but it won't be the same. You know, my way of drumming, yeah, I can keep time. But when the fill, which I always feel is my art, is it has to do with the surrounding atmosphere at that moment.
Little by little, all of the veils were being pulled away, you know, all of the idolatry, all the people he thought were just incredible. And you realize it just, when all is said and done, you only have yourself. And that's just the truth, you know. And he came to that conclusion very quickly in therapy.
I no longer believe in myth, you know, and Beatles is another myth.
People really did think the Mop Tops, the Fab Four, were going to last forever.
It was shocking. I don't believe in the Beatles. I said that in print, Rolling Stone, and on that album.
It was a very big thing with John. He was, you know, he was going through a hard, heavy time of finding himself, dispelling, you know, a lot of his childhood and put into a real space, you know, and searching, like the rest of us, for the meaning of life, as Monty Python said. So, you know, it didn't, for me, I play drums, okay, and if he wants a search, I'll play with you. You know, that's how it was.
Dream's over, like, it's over, you know, and we gotta well, I have, anyway, personally, got to get down to so-called reality.
And that's like one of the key lines in that record. The dream is over.
The Plastic Ono Band LP is the extreme, because you really have John just talking the way he feels.
And he was always brave. He would put it out there. And the consequences sometimes were very harsh, but he would always put it out there. And that's why you could not love him.
It's John Lennon at his most pure, and we've lost him. You know, we lost him in 1980, and we don't know what we would have got had he lived, but we know what he gave us when he was alive. And this record is just so incredibly personal.
It was the biggest statement he could possibly make. There are no compromises in it. You know, there are some beautiful things, but they're not the result of wanting to make something pretty.
The only thing in the world that lasts is that which is real. Plastic Ono Band was real.
He was naked in front of his pain, you know, just straight naked. And it was right there all the time. And he had to deal with it. Some people deal with it by drink and this and that. He dealt with it by writing songs. Luckily for all of us.
It was a revolution for a Beatle to do this, I suppose. You know, to say, listen, I'm human, I'm real, you know. I think it took a lot of courage for him to do it.
You know, I wouldn't like to be interviewed on a lot of records. But this, I don't mind, because it's a beautiful record, and he was a beautiful man, and, you know, I'm privileged to feel he was my friend.
There's another chance to see our drama Lennon naked here on BBC4 tonight at 20 to midnight. And coming up next, there's a rock shrine to the man himself.